Good evening all, and welcome to the virtual graduation of Hansberry class of 2020. Starting high school, I remember thinking to myself that graduating in 2020 was so far away, especially at a structured high school like Hansberry. However, it was my goal to graduate high school on time. I knew that achieving this goal would take a lot of hard work, so I started to plan my life accordingly. I knew that going to high school, I shouldn't be scared to ask questions about new topics or even attend the office hours that were set in place to help me understand things that I didn't understand in class. When you set goals for yourself, I believe it gives a person more motivation to reach it, due to the simple fact that setting goals also requires planning in order to know the path that we will take to get there. Having plans to achieve goals show that you are committed and in control of where you want to be in your life, rather than waiting around for something that changes the circumstances of your life. However, there is one thing that we must consider when setting goals. The path to success is not straight, but that should not stop our journey to success. For example, our senior year, we all had plans to walk across the stage in front of all of our loved ones, but look at where we are. That did not stop us from being determined to ensure that we received our diplomas at the end of the school year. During this current climate of social unrest, having goals as an African American can be viewed as two ways. One, far-fetched, or we can use that as fuel to go harder than ever. In this given moment, this should be the time where we truly embody the HBC core value of persistence in order to keep us motivated throughout our journey of achieving our goals. Therefore, we stand here today celebrating our achievements and moving one step closer to the goals that we have set for ourselves when we were little kids. To those of us who are going off to college or those of us going straight into the workforce, even those who are taking the year just to figure it all out, this moment is ours. It is now time for us to enter into adulthood and start making decisions towards our goals that we've set for ourselves. Or as Ms. Williams would put it, live life, do you? But I believe that attending this school has played a significant role in shaping and preparing us into the people that we are today by continuously teaching us lessons that we can use to set and achieve our goals as we move away from our high school careers. So remember, set goals, plan, achieve. Thank you.
To the young men of the Green Advisory, congratulations. Class of 2020, you made it. After all of this, after everything happening in the world, you all made it. When I took over this advisory last year, I did not know what to expect, but I was excited. I had a group of amazing young men who have just like grown right before my eyes. I know you all are gonna do so many great things in the future. You all are smart, you all are resilient, you all are persistent. You all are strong, young men. I am just super excited to hear of all the great things that you all are gonna do in the future and college. I'm excited about your first jobs. I'm excited about the people that you'll meet. I'm excited about the places that you all are gonna go. It is going to be hard. And I'm not gonna lie to you and say that it's not, but you all are just different. You're gonna push through anything. You all are able to overcome whatever comes your way. And I am extremely confident in that. Good luck with everything that you do. And don't forget about all the things that I've told you. You got this. You all are on the road to success. We need you all. And I know you got us. All of y'all. Y'all got us. All right? Good luck in the future. I'm excited. I love you all. And congratulations again. Class of 2020, Green Advisory.
Hello, class of 2020. Miss Greer here. I can't believe the time has come for you to finally embark on the next chapter of your life. They say that teachers are not supposed to have favorite students or favorite classes, but I think everyone watching this video can agree that your class truly holds a special place in our hearts. And of course, no one is more near and dear to my heart than the 11 incredible boys I was blessed to have in my advisory for the past 4 years. Greer boys, words cannot express how much I will miss each and every one of you. Samson, Cortez, Marquise, Giante, Isaiah, Lee, Jaden, Laurel, Cornelius, Jordan, and Dayan. It is because of you that I look forward to coming to Hansberry every day, so thank you for making Hansberry feel like home. While our time together was unfortunately cut short, I will forever cherish every moment that we had together. And remember that wherever you go in life, in the words of Jaden, be a good noodle. I love you all so much. Congratulations, Greer boys forever.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I will certainly miss each of you. And to the Witcher Advisory, in this brief moment, instead of sending you well wishes and words of encouragement to help prepare you for this world, I think it's the perfect opportunity to instead prepare the world for how great each of you are. So for those of you watching, today I had 26 beautiful Black resilient ladies earn a high school diploma to help propel them to their next educational feat. And it was a pleasure to watch them grow. And as they enter the real world, I need you to be prepared for them and not overlook their greatness, because they have it. I need you to be prepared for Jemiah and Jalea and Taishima and Lariah's ability to excel despite challenges. I need you to be prepared for Ayana and Miracle and Nikasia's ability to lead from anywhere in a room. Alex, Imani, Michaela, Jemiah, Tyler, whose potential is beyond what they can fathom right now. I need you to be ready for Talia and Shaquandria and Tashana and Iman, who already command rooms like CEOs. And I need you to be prepared for Jada and Ashley and Jessica and Tanaya, who persevere and prevail at all costs. And I need you to be ready for Kiera and Jayla and Vernice, whose worth ethic is unmatched. And lastly, I need you to be ready for Kiara and Ashanti and Destiny and Zoe's passionate and unapologetic desire to fight for what they know they deserve. So to the Witchers, thank you for the opportunity to grow with you. To the Witcher parents, thank you for trusting me with your child, and thank you for allowing me to be on this journey with you all. also thank you for blessing me with one of the 26 children that I will never forget. So once again, to all of you, congratulations, world. Be ready for the class of 2020 from HCP. They are special. They are amazing. They matter.
Hello, everyone. First, I want to take a moment to say thank you to my girls' families. Thank you for your constant support throughout the years to ensure that we made it to this day, graduation. I cannot express how unbelievably grateful I am to you all for everything you have done to help me and your babies. Now to my girls. I want to tell you that I am so proud of you. I have seen you all mature into amazing, strong, independent young women who are going to do amazing things in this world. Since your freshman year, you all have remained focused and committed to achieving your goals. Together, we have shared in the struggles of life, but we have also shared in so many moments of laughter. As you move into this next part of your life, I am reminded of a quote that says, "Failure is not the opposite of success. It's a part of it." So my hope for you is that you do not let the fear of the unknown or the fear of failure stop you from pursuing amazing opportunities and experiences. Life will get difficult as you carve your new paths. Always remember that you have people in your corner that are cheering you on. I promise to still be a text, phone call, or email away if you need encouragement and support, or if you just need somebody to yell at you to fix your face and get it together. Always remember that you are loved. I am going to miss you so much, but I cannot wait for all of the updates on the amazing things that your life will bring. Congratulations, my tough cookies, and congratulations to the class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You made it, and I am extremely proud of all of you, especially the young and talented Black men of the Ward Advisory. Today, as we celebrate, let's remember our advisory member, Markeith Jones. Although he's gone, he's here with us in beautiful memories and in spirit. Gentlemen, today I leave you with gratitude and a charge. First, thank you to the Ward Advisory parents for allowing me to partner with you in edifying your sons and their Black boy joy. Gentlemen, thank you for trusting me to advise you through your destined time at HCP, for being amazing big brothers to Shiloh and Aiden, and for the multiple laughs and daily opportunities forcing me to be an even better advisor. And now the charge. Gentlemen, your greatness is unmatched, but it's not complete. You have progressed beyond many destinations, but you have much further to go. You have persisted through adversity, but there are many more challenges ahead. Our motto is to strive. It is both present and your future. You must keep moving forward towards greatness, going the distance, and overcoming more obstacles. Young, Black, educated men, it is now more than ever that you are needed to impact this world. To be in the room and to sit at the tables to dismantle the systems of oppression that have tried to hold you down and to hold our people down. Go, agitate, disrupt, teach, protest, dismantle, learn, and vote. Kick down, bust through, and open doors. Shatter ceilings and create new floors. Go be great. As a matter of fact, redefine greatness, because the Ward Advisory is expected to succeed with tenacity, reaching integrity, valor, and excellence, moving forward, upward, and onward. Ward Advisory, congratulations.
To my lovely advisory, I have been writing this speech since your junior year, well before we became an even bigger family in your senior year. But how I feel about each and every one of you is the same. You have all grown into the intelligent, self-possessed, empathetic, and supportive young women that I would have wanted to befriend, to laugh and cry with, and to work alongside when I was your age. I cannot wait for you to be those women for the communities that you will be a part of in your future endeavors. I love you all so much. To the class of 2020, it has been a true honor to teach and love so many of you. Hansberry will not be the same without your boisterous spirits roaming throughout our halls. But the world awaits you, so we have to bid you bye-bye for now, because we know that there is nothing but success and fulfillment in your futures. Congratulations, and thank you for changing our lives. Go change some more.
Hello, class of 2020. We finally made it to high school graduation, but we all know it wasn't easy to get here. There have been ample amounts of times where we just wanted to give up, not caring what the end result may be. However, we've endured too much to give up, both as a collective and individually. As a collective, we've seen many of our favorite teachers leave. Ms. Dordo, Mrs. Cole, Ms. Cruz, and Mr. Smith, just to name a few. Individually, you might have lost family members or had heartfelt experiences that tore us down, especially the loss of our dearest classmate, Marquise Jones. But that didn't stop us. We kept pushing because we knew what our end goal was. We helped one another because we knew it wasn't easy. Whether it was lending a shoulder to cry on, offering encouragement or motivation, or simply giving a hug. As a result, those heartbreaking moments soon turned into bittersweet memories. A particular moment we all cherish was receiving our light blue college polos. Those polos represent accomplishment, hard work, and sacrifice. Throughout high school, we all experienced something that taught us lessons. Those lessons are now stories that we can share. For example, learning that it is okay to not get everything right the first time. In the beginning of each school year, we all made goals for ourselves to get good grades and have less to no disciplinary infractions. However, we sometimes came upon difficult times. One example we all have experienced is getting a failing grade on a test. Even though all of their tests were not completely easy, they were still a little challenging. However, we learned from those mistakes. We went to office hours to fix those mistakes. The same goes for disciplinary infractions. Everyone has gotten a demerit at some point in the school year, maybe even on the first day. But those demerits have taught us to not do those things again. Actually, they have made us into better individuals. Our mistakes teach us that it is okay to not get everything right the first time. As time goes on, we get better. Hence our light blue college polos. This is also a life lesson that teaches us it's okay to make mistakes because we are not perfect human beings. Even though this is one of many accomplishments, we are not done. We didn't make it this far just to stop here. Let's continue to set goals for ourselves and prove that we are destined to be great and successful, especially as Black kings and queens. In today's world, it's becoming rare for Black teens to graduate high school and attend college. Let's prove that we can go beyond the expectation and that there are future Black leaders, CEOs, educators, artists, and etc. that are capable of being as successful as our white counterparts. In the midst of all this darkness right now, let's find and shine our light. Our light will pave the way for our future, which is destined to be bright. We have a purpose in life, so let's fulfill it. Let's be great, class of 2020, by all means.
Class of 2020, congratulations. I could not be more proud of you. Not only did you complete 4 years of high school, which comes with its own unique set of opportunities and challenges, you did so in the midst of something that this country has not seen in over 100 years. Whether you realize it or not, you, the class of 2020, are strong, you are resilient, you are our class of endurers. I stand in awe of you. I really do. And I want you to know that you have the power to do anything. You've already demonstrated that you can do anything. Hold on to that power. You're going to need it because I have to be honest with you. Life is going to continue to throw you many challenges. There are going to be struggles. There will be moments of self-doubt and insecurity in college and beyond, but that's okay. Remember this moment. Remember everything that you've been through. You can do this. And I also want you to know that you are worthy. You are about to enter classrooms and boardrooms. There are gonna be times when you're gonna be the only one in that room who looks like you, and there'll be other times where you might be surrounded by hundreds who look like you. But regardless, I want you to own your space, own your story, own that seat, and own your destiny. You deserve to be there. Where you might have left our physical buildings several months ago because of this pandemic, know that you never left our hearts. You never left our noble family. And because you're graduating, that doesn't mean that you're leaving our noble family. You will always be here with us. Please don't hesitate to reach out if you need anything whatsoever. We love you. We are so proud of you. I cannot wait to see what the world has in store for you. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Michael Adams. Devin Z. Alexander. Ashley Arrington. Emerald Arrington.
Hello, I would like to thank all my teachers, especially Ms. Cho, because she stayed on me. God, my creator, and I love everybody. Love and miss you.
Vernice L. Austin. Leandrew J. Banks. Jeffrey Barber. Leroy E. Barnes. Jada M. Bell. Jala Bell. Miracle Rose Black. Ashanti C. Bodie. Derek D. Brown. Deshaun D. Brumfield. Taishima B. Bryant. Jaden Cannon. Tomasita G. Cole. Ania L. Commander. Brendan Cooper. Tashawn Cora. Jemiah A. Durkins. Lee C. Douglas. Marquise Jeffrey Dothard. Nikesha K. Dukes. Dion Shamar Epps.
Hey everybody, it's me, Dion Epps, the class of 2020 graduate. I'm so proud of everybody. I'm going to Coe College in the fall, class of 2024. Woohoo, we did it.
Alicia Jayla Ferguson. Tariah Patricia Fitch. Cornelius Ford. Cortez Edward Ford. Tashana A. Gandhi. Jontai M. Gillespie. Isaiah Nicholas Grant. Samson Gregory. Jacqueline D. Grice. Laurel Hall. Jessica Seju Henderson. Jasmine Hendricks. Tanaya N. Herford. Kendra Charisse Hill. Kenyatta L. Holmes. Jacoby Bryson Hull.
I just want to say thank you for all the hard work that you've put into my education these 4 years. I'm going to take all the lessons that you've given me in the future. Thank you.
Alila M. Jackson. Journey S. Jackson. Kevin Lamont Jackson.
Thank you to everyone who supported me through my high school experience. You know who you are. I appreciate you.
Patrick M. Jackson Jr. Jessica M. Johnson. Michael A. Johnson.
Thank you, Hansberry, for everything. And to my peers and to the class of 2020, stay resilient and stay true to yourself and the people who support you.
Dorian B. Jones. Jalen D. Jones. Markeith Jones.
Today, the Ward Advisory remembers and celebrates Markeith Jones. Markeith, you are with us forever in spirit and...
Naomi S. Jones. Vincent Jordan. Diamond Brianna Lee. Joanna Lisa Lee. Ashante Sherry Lee. Kiara Lewis. Bertel B. Lowry. Jariah Courtney Mack. Joseph McKinley. Lauren Denise Mackey. Jordan Martin. Justin Tremaine Martin. Jared Elijah McCoy. Kiara Calise McChriston. Taylor Ryan McNeil. Doshira Duchess Irene Melton. Courtney Morris. Cassidy V. Myers. Abby Undaye.
Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Jalen Armani Neal. Jelani Newburn. Destiny D. Newell.
Thank you, ACP, for helping me become a well-rounded individual. With your hard work and dedication, I can finally say that I made it.
Tierra Renee Nobles. Rakaya Alia Norris. Tamara H. Otis. Dakan J. Pennington. Brenisha Kira Potts.
I'm Brenisha Potts, and I would like to say congratulations to Class of 2020. I can't wait to see what everyone accomplishes in college.
Carlton Powell. Jaden Maku Price. Donnell D. Redding. Sydney Riddle. Alfred Rose. Darcel L. Royster. Jeremiah J. Sandifer. Asandi M. Sani. Ashanti R. Sani. Classity Scales. Alexandria A. Sims. Kian Lewis Sims. Iman A. Smith. D'Angelo J. Sparkman. Mishyla J. Staples. Imani D. Thaxton. Gracie Thomas. Jemiah A. Tyler. Jayla A. Walker. Ayanya Wallace. Jakai T. Washington. Laraya D. Washington. Talia Ariana Wilborn. Joel M. Williams. Zoe R. Williams. Damarian R. Wilson. Jalea Z. Wimberly. Chicondria A. Wolf. Eileek J. York.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. This year was different. It was a difficult time to graduate in a world riddled with uncertainty. I'm here to reinforce what you already know. You did that. You made it through. I also want to name, while this moment in time is different, living in a life full of uncertainty is not. Life can be messy. There are no straight lines, and things rarely go as planned. There will always be challenges and barriers that seemingly pop up out of nowhere. This is okay. Your goal is to constantly see doors where there may appear to be walls. You've already demonstrated your ability to do this and to do it well. Go back with me. Remember your freshman year. You did not know how you were going to navigate the halls of HCP. You did not know how you were going to make it through. Yet you adapted. You worked through all of the challenging moments in order to get to this one. My challenge to you all as we enter into this uncertain world, focus on the possibility. Don't be afraid to run through new doors. Take advantage of all that you have learned and have already persisted through. Think and talk less about what you are against and focus on those things that you love, those things that bring you joy, and those things that you are committed to change. This world needs your excellence now more than ever. Our country is woefully divided. We are still, as people of color, navigating systems that were not built to consider our humanity or our equal rights to a just society predicated on freedom. Despite the flawed systems and notion of inferiority, because of who we are, who our ancestors were, we have made progress. And we demand more. We deserve more. It is now your turn to enter this fight. It is your turn to break down barriers and put yourself in positions to not only get access to the decision-making table, but to ensure the system is dismantled and rebuilt for all to reap the promises of this country. You all are more than capable of creating this change. You are the revolutionaries, the special ones, those that cannot be broken. You'll forever be known as the class that kept it together despite things around falling apart. You're special and full of possibility despite any uncertainty. Congratulations, class of 2020. We love you, and your HCP family will always, always be here for you.
We're gonna pop it open. Hey, that's the contest.